involved some penalties associated with that intersection angle between A and B configurations. Nevertheless, let me just show you the results associated with such post-Hermitian amplitudes. We have standard fermionic, synovial parts, and phantom parts, and the complicated Hermitian integral over hypergeometric functions of that type. Compared to the result of 10 to the 4th string amplitude, it's much simpler expression. So what we wanted to do is, with the Fermi amplitude calculation, we wanted to compare direct string effects associated with those Fermi interactions relative to the field theory effects. So
I don't have cross-interactions. Another thing I can tell you is
there's not a super potential there, stability of that, and that also, you know, we definitely have this layer, and so there are a lot of things to be studied because the consequences are really much more general structure of this construction. Yes, Mike. I'm assuming they are here. Yes, indeed. This is the same reason. Otherwise, the program would have decayed a long time by now, right? The way it's good. Yes. Anyway, everybody will go out, basically, right? So the assumption is that we assume that biosimilarity is not dimension 5, but so we focus on dimension 6. Okay? But as you saw, well, I mean, my advertiser actually thinks that could push lifetime effect to be shorter. But it's still really not where the future experiments will reach. You know, 5 to 35 seconds is the lifetime that comes from there. But nevertheless, it's also an exercise when you can really calculate the distance. Yeah. First of all, we don't have that much statistics, but let me tell you immediately. In the second distinct brain construction as such, if you want to map it onto the parodic one, necessarily requires NS5 brains, because distinct brains, some of them will map into NS5 brains. This construction is a preservative on type 2A side. I mean, then you're not a preservative on the parodic side. The reason it doesn't need preservative map, really. Well, let's emphasize the geometry on that side, all right? All the other pictures, actually, we have the right geometry. Other pictures, maybe more, I want them to get started in other pictures, but they're less geometric. Right, so I should say, I was indicating that the traversal strong coupling regime, not the relative effect, to turn off such coupling. I'm talking MPO on G2. Okay? Because there you know, look at the lot of variety of those couplings are there. So we do expect that they are non-preservative. But here they are small in preservative type 2A pictures. So basically, look, these effects were all pushed to the anterior limit because the dimension 6 operator calculation, if I take small G string, the string effects are too small, I have to take the current to be over 1 and enhance it by vessel correction. So basically, I have given you the best, the anterior limit result associated with it. Yeah, but the effect, I'm pushing it to the limit of the S of over 1. No. Basically, it's not a, I'm inventing that, right? The basic mode, 10 to the 4, was done by 700 Wilson. Yeah. Well, in the decoupling limit, it's rather small effects, right? So it's very, I'm trying to get the larger one that will still somehow control my calculation. It is a personality calculation. That is a personality construction. And I didn't take G sub S infinity, I take G sub S to be 1. Okay, so I am pushing it in this regime. I'm saying it, look, there are certain features that we can address within the context, right? Well, others don't work, right? So we completely drop those supports because something else, you know, some other issues are problems. Well, but the previous numbers for us, I've got to ask, okay? Anyway, 335 in that sense would be somewhat less severe because there you have top mass, preservativity, and bottom mass, which is non-preservativity, that's right. But the calculation would look like very much lower with the factor with the 335 as well. Okay, no difference.
Okay, so the next speaker is another Marshall Brunner from LMU, and he'll be talking about co-isotropic models. Okay, so I'm surprised that this is primarily a conference with some guys, I think, as a thinker, rather than digging deeply into the details of any one particular piece of cosmological phenomenology. I decided that a useful thing today would be to give a very broad overview of the various things that exist in the data, or the various things that might be looking in the data, that would be of interest to people who were building cosmological models and product thinking. So the foundation point on is that some of the opinions and work that I've looking at today, based on relates to a bunch of different countries that I'm looking at with my collaborators, I look to support particularly a book from Adolf, as Ingen Kane, Vine Green, Wilkinney, using them in the process of trying to see it from a track. Thank you. any more data coming in for at least a couple of decades. So we're never going to be fully working on the point where we retired. I think the tech technology is really in the position that particle physics might have been for the last few years. So it's been a long time before, you know, we've seen a long drought between different particle physics things and some significant new data to look at. And so we've done a little bit of stuff, but this is just some really honest work. I can tell, as many of the students who learned how to quantize the fields in a little bit of GR, I can tell them how to calculate the basic perturbations for superfunctional perturbations that come in the standard superfluid and saturated models. So what we're going to say, yeah, we're hearing from other people who are non-gap reality, with some of the complicated phenomenology we might be worried about today, but there's only really to work out at the moment for 25 years or more after a question was invented. And first of all, I want to mention names since I know the question was reported, that
Thank you.
money to pay. I think it's a risk that they're putting the noise.
The non-gap identity, the largest main field. And it's very interesting, I'm looking at the non-gap identity, the inner direction.
field is very difficult. But I'm focusing on things that have infield gradients directly to each other, which are not directly coupled to each other. And this is motivated by this impression model that was written down by Demopoulos, Kaplan, and Levy, and Jacko last year. And it's actually multiple axions and 40 flux axes. It's a reason to predict by shift symmetry, but they act collectively to produce something that looks like a single infield bisphere interphone. But each of the fields is only moving by a size distance much less than M plane. And this is a situation that people have written down sometime in the past and running the scripted instructions. And so we have copies of one quadratic field, and the original analysis that masses were seen to be degenerate. And what the last year, Liam McAllister and I actually managed to argue